Clouds can weigh up to 1.1 million pounds. That's like 500,000 kg. But the question is, when you measure cloud, what do you really measure? Is it ice crystals, water droplets, or cloud droplets itself? In a study done by US National Atmospheric Research, they considered a medium-sized cumulus cloud. And approximately a medium-sized cloud of this type can be as long as 1 kilometer. How did they figure this out, you may ask? Well, cumulus clouds are huge, and similarly the shadow they cast are huge as well, so they can measure the length by the shadow. Also, a point to note is that cumulus clouds are roughly like a cube, so we can assume same length for height as well. Now we got the height and length, and now the next step is to get density. If you watched my previous videos on how clouds are formed, we see that they are made up of water droplets and ice crystals, and in this study scientists figured out the density of up to 1 by 2 grams, 0.5 grams of water per cubic meter. Now if you do the math, you'll get 1 billion cubic meter, and if you multiply it by density, you'll get around 500,000 kilogram. So we know now how to measure the weight of a cloud. But with this much weight, 500,000 kilograms, it's like 100 elephants. The next question you may think of is that, why don't they fall on us? Well, this has to do with two things actually. Clouds are made up of many water droplets, so the weight is spread over, just like water droplets are spread over at a huge distance. So it's actually floating with very less weight. And second point is that air under the cloud is more dense and drier, which makes the cloud to float and never fall on us. Well, actually it does fall eventually, but not directly. Clouds are amazing, and there are many things which you might not know. And we can learn so much from nature if you just look around.